Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Paryani. In this session, we are going to discuss about third problem in consignment accounting. So this is still the cost price method, but in this question we have abnormal loss. In my previous sessions, we have already solved two problems, but in those problems abnormal loss was not given. So now let us try to understand how to solve problem when abnormal loss is also given in the question. If you want the link of the previous video, I'll provide you the link of the whole playlist of this chapter in the description box below or at the end of this video. So keep watching. Raghu consigned 500 sewing machines to Ramesh. The cost price of each machine is ₹1,200. Okay, he paid ₹1,880 for packing and ₹4,000 for freight and insurance. During the transit, 50 machines were totally damaged and the insurance company settled the claim for ₹500. See here, damage is given, right? Basically, Raghu is the consigner. He is consigning goods to Ramesh. So Ramesh is the consignee. The cost price of each unit or each machine is also given. The expenses of the consigner are also given. After that, it's given that 50 machines were totally destroyed. So it means that this is the abnormal loss. Okay. Ramesh took the delivery of remaining goods by paying ₹1,320 for octroi. He returned 10 machines as they were unsaleable. Now, consignee is taking the delivery of the goods and he is paying for some of the expenses. And he is returning some of the machine because they cannot be sold. Okay, by paying ₹1,000 for freight. Then he incurred ₹3,000 for selling expenses and sold 420 machines at ₹1,500 each. So his selling expenses are also given and sales is also given in the question. He settled the balance due by bank draft and he is entitled to a commission of 5% on sales. So consignee's rate of commission is also given. Now we are asked to prepare necessary accounts in the books of both the parties. Okay, so first of all, I would like to tell you that how many accounts or which accounts we need to prepare for this question. Okay, so first of all, as they have told, prepare necessary accounts in the books of both the parties. It means in the books of consigner as well as in the books of consignee, we have to prepare certain accounts. Okay, so first let us understand in the books of consigner, which are the accounts we need to prepare. Consigner. So the first account that we need to prepare in the books of consigner is consignment account. So this is the main account in the books of consigner. Then after that we have to prepare consignee's account. After that we have to prepare goods sent on consignment account. Okay, so these three are the main accounts that we need to prepare in the books of consigner. But when abnormal loss is given in the question, then we have to prepare another extra account, that is abnormal loss account. Okay, so in my previous sessions, we have done only these three accounts. But abnormal loss account is the new one in this problem, right? So we don't have to forget that consignment account is the main account and remaining of them are just cross posting. So if you prepare this account properly, then these all will be easy. Okay, so these are the accounts you need to prepare in the books of consigner. Now in the books of consignee, we need to prepare consigner's account. So this account is the main account in the books of consignee. Okay. Second one we have to prepare commission account. But this is optional. Okay. So few of them prepares and few of them don't prepare. But again this is also cross posting from this account. So how, I'll tell you. Okay. So basically you have to prepare in total 6 accounts. But commission account is optional. If you want you can do it. But I will show you. Okay, so in order to prepare these accounts, we have to do some working notes first. Okay, so basically we have to do two working notes in this question. Working note 1 and 2. So the first working note that we have to do is, we have to find the value of abnormal loss. See, in the question, it will be given that certain number of machines, 10 machines are destroyed. It's returns, right? 50 machines were totally damaged. So it's given that 50 machines are damaged, but what is the value of those machines? We don't know that. So first of all, we have to find the value of abnormal loss. And this value has to be shown in the consignment account. So before preparing consignment account, we have to do this working note. Okay. And second working note we have to do is value of closing stock. So this working note is compulsory for all the questions. Before going for the consignment account, we have to find out the value of closing stock. Okay, so the information about this will not be directly given in the question, but we can easily find it out. Okay, again, the value of closing stock has to be shown in the consignment account. So that's why before preparing consignment account, we prefer finding the value of closing stock. Okay, in certain questions, when abnormal loss is not given, we don't have to do this working note. But this working note, value of closing stock, is compulsory for all the questions. Is that clear? So now let's start with working notes first, then we will go for the main accounts. Okay, first let us find out the value of abnormal loss. So calculation of value of abnormal loss, or simply you can write valuation of abnormal loss. Now in order to find this out, we need to refer the question, as well as we have a small format for finding out the value. This I have already explained in my previous sessions. We have done many problems also on this. So right now you can take the screenshot of this, then you can refer it until you practice it and get to know that. Okay, so now I am referring this format and finding out the value of closing stock, value of abnormal loss. Okay, so quickly I'll just tell you, first of all, we have to find out the cost price of the goods lost. Okay, how many goods are lost? Its cost price should be found out. So how we will find it? Quantity lost into cost price per unit. In our question, 50 machines have been lost, right? So each the cost price of the each unit is also given. So we'll do it as 50 into cost price. Okay, then we have to add proportionate total non-recurring expenses up to loss. Now here the main task is finding out which are the non-recurring expenses. We have to remember that while valuing abnormal loss as well as closing stock, we should just take non-recurring expenses into the consideration. Okay, so I'll tell you which are the non-recurring expenses when we will refer the question. So total non-recurring expenses up to loss into quantity lost divided by quantity sent minus if there are any returns. So when we will simplify this, we'll get certain value. And when we add both of these values, we'll get the value of abnormal loss. Okay, so I'll tell you how to do it. Now in our question, Raghu consigned 500 sewing machines to Ramesh. The cost price of each machine is rupees 1200. So this is important now. He paid rupees 1880 for packing, rupees 4000 for freight and insurance. During the transit, 50 machines were totally damaged and insurance company settled the claim for rupees 500. See, first of all, what we have to do, as I told, we have to find the cost price of the goods lost. Okay, so we have to find it as quantity lost into cost price. So by the question, just now we came to know 50 machines are totally destroyed. Okay, so 50 machines are lost, right? And the cost price of each machine given is rupees 1200. So 50 into 1200. So we have to multiply it. Then we'll get the answer as rupees 60,000. Okay, write it in the amount column. Then after that, we have to add proportionate non-recurring expenses. So now I'll tell you which are the non-recurring expenses up to loss. So before loss, only consigner's expenses should be taken into consideration. okay, and almost all the expenses of consignor are non-recurring expenses only. Okay, now check in question, which are the expenses of consignor are given. So here it's given that he paid ₹1,880 for packing and 4,000 for freight and insurance, right? So only these two expenses of consignor are given. We have to add both of these. So first write it as plus proportionate total non-recurring expenses up to loss. Okay, so this loss has happened before the goods reach to consignee, right? So only we are taking the non-recurring expenses of the consignor. So 4,000 plus 1,880. In total, it will be 5,880 into quantity lost is 50 machines divided by quantity sent given in the question is 500 machines. Okay, so in this, if there are any returns, then we have to deduct it. So in question, it's given he returned 10 machines, right? So minus 10. Okay, so when we simplify this, we'll get the value as 600, right? Now what we have to do, we have to total both of this. That is 60,600 is the value of abnormal loss, right? Now this value has to be shown in the consignment account. So after this, let us find out the value of closing stock. Okay, so as I shown you the format for calculating value of abnormal loss, similarly we also have a format for finding the value of closing stock. Even this I have explained in my previous sessions, so you can check it out. The link for whole playlist will be provided. Okay, so again this format we have to follow to find out the value of closing stock. Okay, so I'll do it, then I'll explain you. First of all, we have to find out the quantity of closing stock. So how we will find it? Quantity of closing stock is equal to, first we have to take the amount of the quantity of goods sent, right? So 500 machine have been sent, in that you have to deduct quantity returned. So in question it's given 10 machine have been returned, right? Quantity sold, now check how many goods are sold in the question. Sold 420 machines, right? So 420 machines have been sold. Okay, minus if there is any quantity of abnormal loss. So quantity of abnormal loss is also there, right? 50 machines have been destroyed. So 500 minus 10 minus 420 minus 50. So if we do it, we get the value as 20. Now 20 machines are remain unsold, or 20 machines are is the quantity of closing stock. Okay, but here we have to find out the value of closing stock. This is just the quantity. So for finding the value of closing stock, you have to again find the cost price or invoice price of the closing stock. So this question is in cost price, right? So we'll find cost price for closing stock. How to find it? Again same, quantity of closing stock into cost price per unit. Okay, so quantity of closing stock we came to know, that is 20. First write cost price of closing stock. So quantity of closing stock we came to know, that is 20, into cost price per unit is given in the question, that is 1200 rupees per machine. Okay, so when you multiply this, we get the value as rupees 24,000. Write it in the amount column. Then we have to add again proportionate non-recurring expenses of consignor, and then also we have to add proportionate non-recurring expenses of consignee. Okay, in the valuation of normal loss, we have just taken the non-recurring expenses of consignor, but while valuing closing stock, we have to take expenses of both the parties. So first let's add non-recurring expenses of consignor. Okay, so we have done the calculation here. All of these will be same. So 5,880 are total non-recurring expenses into quantity of closing stock here is 20. So divide by quantity sent is 500 minus quantity returns is 10. Okay, so if you simplify this, we'll get the value as rupees 240. Okay, write it in the amount column. Then add non-recurring expenses of consignee. Now here we have to find out which are the non-recurring expenses of consignee. See, I told you, usually consigners' expenses are all non-recurring expenses. But from expenses of consignee, you have to find out which are the non-recurring expenses and which are the recurring expenses. Right? So how can you find out? So basically, non-recurring expenses are the expenses which occur as per sales, which depend upon sales. It means if we do not do much of the sales, those expenses will not be incurred. But there will be certain expenses also, which no matter we do sales or not, they will be recurring. Like for example, we have to pay the rents, then we have to do advertising, we have to make the selling expenses no matter if we are selling or not. But expenses like octroi, like freight, like loading and unloading, these occurs only when the sales are made, right? So here Ramesh took delivery of the remaining goods by paying 1,320 for octroi, right? This is the non-recurring expense of the consignee. He returned 10 machines as they were unsellable by paying rupees 1,000 for freight. Now you should not take this. This expense is while returning, so just leave it. He incurred 3,000 for selling expenses and sold 420 machine. Selling expenses are, remember, these are recurring expenses. Okay, so we should not take them. We should only take rupees 1,320. So 1,320 into quantity of closing stock is 20 divided by, here look at here, the formula here is quantity sent minus quantity returns minus quantity of abnormal loss. See, while calculating non-recurring expenses of consignor, there was no abnormal loss, right? But here we have to deduct quantity of abnormal loss also. So quantity sent is 500 minus returns are 10 minus quantity of abnormal loss is 50. Okay, so when we simplify this, we get the answer as rupees 60, right? So in total, we will get, when you add these three, remember you should not add this 20 because this is not the value. This is the quantity of closing stock. Okay, in order to do these calculations, we have to find quantity. So now you just have to add these three amount, right? So when you add it, you get the value of rupees 24,300. Okay, this will be the value of closing stock. Again, this value we have to show it in the consignment account. So value of abnormal loss is also found out, value of closing stock is also found out. Both of these values should be shown in the consignment account, right? So now let us prepare consignment account, which is the main account in the books of the consignor. So we have a format for it. So according to this, we will be going on solving it. Okay. So refer the question first. Raghu consigned 500 sewing machines to Ramesh. So this has to be recorded. Usually consignment account starts with the opening stock, but in most of the cases opening stock will not be given. So first we have to record the entry for which the consigner sends the goods to consignee on the debit side of the consignment account. So we can record it as goods sent to consignment, goods sent on consignment. So 500 sewing machines are sent at the rate of rupees 1200 each, right? So 500 into 1200. So here we'll get the value as rupees 6 lakh. Okay, next. He paid ₹1,880 for packing and ₹4,000 for freight and insurance. So next, consigner's expenses are given. So again, expenses we know that needs to be recorded on the debit side. So because these are the consigner's expense, we will record it as bank account expenses of consigner. For packing, he incurred ₹1,880. And for freight, he incurred ₹4,000. So in total, he incurred ₹5,880 as expenses. Okay, expenses of consigner should be recorded as bank account. Okay, because we are preparing accounts in the books of consigner itself, right? So in the books of consigner, we cannot take the name of consigner here, or we cannot even mention consigner account. That is why we are mentioning as bank account. Okay, so during the transit, 50 machines were totally damaged and the insurance company settled the claim for ₹500. So this damage entry, for this we have calculated the value of abnormal loss, right? So I'll tell you. Then after that, we have Ramesh took delivery of the remaining goods by paying ₹1,320 for octroi. He returned 10 machines as they were unavailable by paying ₹1,000 for freight. He incurred ₹3,000 for selling expenses. So now consignee is taking the delivery and he is paying for many expenses. Right now we have to record consignee's expenses. So again, expenses will be recorded on the debit side. So we can write it as consignee's account, or you can also mention the name of the consignee. Okay, you can also write it as Ramesh account. Okay, Ramesh account expenses paid. Okay, so he is paying expenses like for octroi ₹1,320, for freight ₹1,000, and selling expenses ₹3,000. Okay, so remember, in the consignment account you should take all recurring expenses as well as non-recurring expenses, but while calculating the value of abnormal loss and closing stock, only then we will take the value of non-recurring expenses only. But here you should take all of them. Okay, so total of these will be ₹5,320. Okay, so up to now we have recorded the goods which are sent by the consigner to the consignee, expenses of consigner and expenses of consignee. Okay, next, he incurred ₹300 for selling expenses completed and sold 420 machines at ₹1,500 each. Now we have to record the sales entry. So we know by sales we will get the income. So income will be recorded on the credit side, right? So say we have to record it as Ramesh account or consignee account for sales. Okay, so he is selling 420 machines at the rate of 1500 each. Okay, so 420 into 1500 will be ₹6,30,000. Okay, so this is the amount of sales, right? Next, he settled the balance due by bank draft and he is entitled to a commission of 5% on sales. Now this settlement through bank draft, I will tell you when we will prepare consigner and consignee's account. Okay, now we have to record his commission. See, consigner has to give the commission to the consignee, right? So it is an expense for the consigner. So expense should be recorded on the debit side. You can again mention consignee's name account or consignee's account. So consignee's account, Ramesh account for commission. Okay, so they are telling that he is entitled for 5% on sales. So our sales amount is ₹6,30,000, right? So 6,30,000 into 5 by 100. Okay, so here the amount we will get, that is ₹31,500. Okay, so this much of commission the consigner has to give to consignee, right? Now in the question abnormal loss is given, right? Now only two things are remaining which will directly not be given, but we have made the working note, right? So both of those things we have to record here now. Okay, see, first we have calculated value of abnormal loss, that we have to record, and valuation of closing stock. Value of closing stock is also known, so both of these things has to be recorded on the credit side now. Okay, so abnormal loss account, the value that we found is rupees 60,600, and closing stock, the value of closing stock that we found is rupees 24,300. So you can show it as working note 1 and working note 2. Now another one thing is remaining here. See, in the question it is given he returned 10 machines as they were unsaleable, right? So here what we did, the entry for the goods sent by the consigner to the consignee, right? But here consignee is returning some of the goods back to consigner, so we will do the entry on the opposite side as goods sent on consignment account, goods returned. Okay, so he is returning 10 machines at the cost of same rupees 1200 each. Okay, so when we multiply this, we'll get the amount as rupees 12,000, right? Now everything is recorded in the consignment account. Remember, very few things will appear in the consignment account which we can easily remember. So they are like, first entry will be goods which are sent by the consignor to consignee, and if there are returns, then we will record it on the opposite side. So these two entries are compulsory. Then we will have expenses of consignor and expenses of consignee. After that, the consignee will get the commission. He will sell the goods. Sales entry will be there. In case abnormal loss is given in the question, this entry will be there, or else it won't be there. But closing stock is compulsory. Okay, so just goods sent, goods returned, expenses of consignor, consignee, sales. So on the basis of sales, he'll get commission. Closing stock is compulsory. If there is abnormal loss, then yes, or else no. So only these things will appear maximum in the consignment account. So it's easy to remember the format. So when we will do problem on loading, on invoice price method, then we'll have to charge loading. I'll tell you that when we will do problem on that method, invoice method. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to total both the amount columns and check on which side the balance is more. So here the credit side is bigger. The total here is rupees 7,26,900. Okay, so mention the same amount here, 7,26,900. Now deduct all these items, all these amounts from 7,26,900. So we'll get the balancing figure of rupees 84,200. Okay, so this will go into P&L account. We will call it as profit on consignment business. Okay, if we get the balancing figure on the credit side, again we should mention it as P&L account. It will be called as loss on consignment. Okay, basically it means, here it means that our incomes are more than our expenses. Okay, if you can see properly, these all the expenses, right? Only this is the this is not an expense. So all these things are the expenses. Basically our expenses are less than our incomes, that is why we are getting the profit here. Okay, I hope you are clear with the consignment account. Next we have to prepare consignee's account, same in the books of consignor only. Okay, but this account is very easy, so it's just cross posting. Now what we have to do is refer the consignment account and check wherever the word consignee's account is mentioned. Okay, so first we have ones on the debit side, right? Consignee's account for expenses. Another time we have on the debit side consignee's account for getting commission. Another one time we have on the credit side, that is consignee's account for sales. Okay, so three times we have consignee's account in the consignment account. Now in the consignee's account, what we have to do, wherever the word consignee account is mentioned, we have to do that entry in this account. right? But on the opposite side, suppose here for expenses paid, it's on debit side, right? In the consignee's account, we will record it on credit side, right? Here for sales, it's on credit side, right? In the consignee's account, we will record it at debit side. It's easy, okay? So first, let's record for consignee's account expenses paid on the credit side. We will record it as consignment account for expense paid. Remember, again here you cannot take as Ramesh account or consignee's account because you are preparing his account itself. You cannot take same person's name in the same account. Okay, so we are taking as consignment account. The amount of expenses paid are ₹5,320. Okay, so no calculations required, just mention the same amount. After that, again we have on debit side for commission. So for this entry, we will record again on credit side as consignment account for commission received. Okay, the amount of commission received is ₹31,500. So same amount, no changes. Then we have another one entry at credit side. So here we will record it on debit side. So this entry is for sales, right? So again we will record it as consignment account for sales. Okay, so the amount of sales was ₹6,30,000, right? Now again everything is recorded, other than this nothing should be taken, right? So now what we have to do, again total both the amount columns. Now here debit side is bigger, ₹6,30,000. Now deduct all of these amount from 6,30,000. So we will get the balancing figure of ₹5,93,180. Okay, so remember, now why we prepare consignee's account means we have to know that how much amount the consignee should pay to consigner. Okay, so basically consignee after making sales, he should pay the amount, right? ₹6,30,000 should be paid, but he will pay it after deducting his expenses and commission. Okay, so now remaining this much amount the consignee should pay, it means consignee has the due of this amount over consigner. Okay, now in the question it was given that he settled the balance due by bank draft. So here it means this amount consignee is sending by a bank draft. So here we can mention it as bank account. Okay, balancing figure. So through bank draft he will send this amount to the consigner. Okay, now let us prepare goods sent to consignment account. Okay, again this is also the cross posting. You have to refer consignment account. Check wherever the words goods sent to consignment account is mentioned. Just record those entries in the opposite side. Okay, so once we have it on debit side and another time we have it on credit side. Okay, so other than this we don't have it anywhere. So just two entries will appear. So this one will be on credit side in the goods sent to consignment account and this one on the debit side. Okay, so first record for goods sent. There it was on debit side, right? So here we will record it as consignment account on the credit side. Consignment account for goods sent. Okay, so the value was ₹6 lakh. Okay, and another one time we have entry on the credit side. So here it will be on the debit side. So we will record it as consignment account for goods returned. Okay, the value here was ₹12,000. So 12,000. Right, so only two entries will appear here, nothing else should be taken, just cross posting. Now again total credit side is bigger, ₹6 lakh, and now deduct 12,000 from 6 lakh, so we get the balancing figure of ₹5,88,000. Okay, so this will go to trading account. balancing figure. Okay, next, this is the new account. So up to here we have prepared all these accounts in my previous problems also, but this is the new one. We have to prepare abnormal loss account because it's given in the question. Okay, again, this is also cross posting. See, here in the consignment account we have abnormal loss on the credit side, right? So here we should take it on the debit side, right? First record it as consignment account. In bracket you can write abnormal loss. Okay, so the value we have already calculated, that is rupees 60,600. Mention it here, 60,600. Okay, so other than this, in question there is another entry. Okay, in the question it's given that during the transit 50 machines were totally damaged and the insurance company settled the claim for rupees 50,000. So this has to be recorded in the abnormal loss account. Okay, we will record it on the credit side as cash account. It's nothing but cash is received from the insurance company for this damage. Okay, but they are giving 50,000, so mention it as 50,000. Right, now close the account. Debit side is bigger, 60,600. Okay, 60,600. Remaining 10,600 rupees will go to P&L account. Okay, so this is balancing figure. Right, totally we incurred damage of rupees 60,600, but insurance company gave us claim of rupees 50,000. So remaining 10,600 will be the loss to us. Okay, so it will go to P&L account. Next, we have to prepare accounts in the books of consignee. In the books of consignor, all the accounts are completed. Now let us prepare accounts in the books of consignee. So in the books of consignee, consignor's account is the main account. Okay, so here also we have to do the same thing, that is expenses on the debit side, incomes on the credit side. But here we have to just record the expenses and incomes of the consignor has to give to consignee, right? So let us prepare it. See, check the consignment account now. Now consignor has to give amount for the consignee for two items, right? For this expenses paid and the commission. Both of the amount should be given by the consignor to consignee, right? In return, consignee will give the sales amount back to the consignor, right? So only these things we have to record here. Okay, but on the same side. Okay, this account is not cross posting. We are just recording for consignor here. Okay, so what we can do is, see, giving the amount for expenses to consignor is expense of the consignor, right? So we will record it on the debit side. So we can record it as consignment account for expenses, right? So expenses paid to consignee is rupees 5,320. Other than this, the consignor has to pay amount for the commission, right? So we can write it as commission account. Okay, so commission paid. Amount of commission paid is rupees 31,500. 31,500. So these both are the amount that the consignor has to give to consignee. In return, consignee will make the sales and he will send the amount back to consignor. So on the credit side, as consignment account sales. Okay, so the value of sales is rupees 6,30,000, right? Okay, now everything is done. So just close it. Rupees 6,30,000. Okay, now the balancing figure, if you deduct both of these from this amount, will be rupees 5,93,180. Okay, so now if you notice one thing, the amount that consignee has to pay to consignor and the amount that the consignor has to receive from consignee is same, right? Here, as I told you, this is the due that the consignee has to give to consignor, 5,93,180, and this is the amount that the consignor has to receive. So that is why we will prepare consignee and consignor's account. Okay, so if you get confused here, what you can do is just record these same entries in the consignor account, which we are recording in consignee's account, but on the opposite side. See, on credit side here we have two entries for expense and commission. Here we have same entries on the debit side. Okay, and here we have sales entry on the debit side. So we have here sales entry on the credit side. Just the opposite. Here the consignor will receive the amount. Here the consignee will pay the due amount. Again, he will receive it through bank, right? Because the amount is settled through bank draft. So bank account. Okay, at last, the last account of this problem we have to do is commission account, right? This is optional. If it is asked in the question, you can do it or else just leave it. But again, this is also very simple. So we have commission account in consignor's account, right? Again, just cross posting. So here we can write it as consignor's account. Here it's on debit side, right? So here it will be on credit side for commission. The amount paid was rupees 31,500. That's it. So nothing else should be recorded. So just close it, 31,500 on both the sides. Okay. So the balancing figure, that is balance carried down, will go to P&L account. Okay. So this is called as balancing figure, rupees 31,500. Right. So I hope you are clear with the problem. Okay guys, so this was all about today. If you found it helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to the channel. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.